Now, Bill, bats have driven a suburb so crazy they're prepared to break the law.
Yes, Georgie, the locals have resorted to blasting the bats with air horns to try and move them on. But unfortunately, the noise has attracted other interest from the police.
They're the worst kind of unwelcome neighbours. Noisy, smelly, potentially disease-ridden, and there's thousands of them. Now residents of the sleepy part of Southport have decided to make some noise of their own. They resorted to blasting the flying foxes with foghorns to drive them away, and they say they're getting results.
So I went on to eBay. It arrived last Wednesday. I gave it a go. It worked. And I let the neighbours know.
I was thinking of going and getting one today because the other neighbours have started.
The bats moved into this part of Southport 8 years ago. Frustrated residents say they've tried everything to move them on with no help from government agencies, and the air horns are the last resort. But the agencies were there today under police escort. The Department of Environment arrived to remind residents they're risking jail time and serious fines for disturbing the flying foxes because they're a protected species.
He's happy for us to come inside today and have a chat with you about it.
Oh, if you like.
Yeah, no worries. OK.
Is
now convenient time?
Yep.
But homeowners say they've already paid the price for the unwelcome animals. Some have had to soundproof their homes just to get a good night's sleep.
Well, they wake you an hour before daybreak, and an hour before daybreak in summer is any time between 2 and 4 a.m.
But authorities say distressed bats are more likely to spread the Hendra virus and have told the residents to make their peace with the pests. On the Gold Coast, Simon Hooper, 10 News.